conference is meant for announcing the detailed schedule for the Panchayat elections. You would recall that on 16th of September, we had come out with the phases for the Panchayat elections also. Panchayat elections would be, the first notification will be issued tomorrow, that is on 23rd of October. And there will be total 9 phases. Every phase will be separated by about 2 to 3 days gap. And the last phase, which is the 9th phase, will be on 14th of November 2018. In each phase, we will be having the same process of nominations. There will be 7 days time for filing nominations. There will be a scrutiny on the next day. If it's a holiday, then the day next to that. And 2 days from then would be the last date of withdrawal. So if you look at it, 23rd October phase, the last date for withdrawal of candidature would be 2nd of November. And in case there's a requirement of poll, then the poll will be taken on 17th of November 2018. So the first phase starts on 23rd October, and in case the polling is required, then the poll date would be 17th of November. I will quickly go through the various phases, the dates of commencement and the date of poll. The second phase starts on 26th October, and the date of poll is 20th November, BIS November. The third phase is 29th October. It starts on that day, and the date of poll is 24th of November. The fourth phase is 1st of November, it starts, and the date of poll is 27th November. The fifth phase starts on 3rd of November. The date of poll is 29th November. The sixth phase starts on 6th of November. The date of poll is 1st December. The seventh phase starts on 9th of November, and the date of poll would be 4th of December. The eighth phase is 12th November, with the date of poll is 8th of December. And the last phase, that's the ninth phase, is going to commence on 14th November, and the date of poll would be 11th of December. So we expect that all the 9 phases, with the completion of that, the Panchayat elections, all Panchayat halkas would elect the sarpanches and panch for their respective areas. Now, at the time when I held the previous press conference, the electoral roll for the Panchayat elections was under the process of finalization. When we had published the draft roll on 18th of August, total number of voters that we had was 58,12,429, and these rolls have now been finalized. We had followed the process of the required process of asking people for claims and objections, and then after due inquiry they are included in the electoral rolls. The total number of electors for the Panchayat election are 58,54,208. So there's been increase in the number of electors who have been added for the in the Panchayat draft roll. In all, there are, you are aware, there are 316 blocks. These 316 blocks have 4,483 Panchayat halkas, 4,483 Panchayat halkas, and the number of panch constituencies is 35,029. You would again notice some variation from the previous figures of the press release which was there on 16 September, because during this period of time we have tried to make sure that every possible court direction which has been received by us or by the directors of rural development, they are acted upon, and we take decisions with regard to the Panchayat halkas, panch constituencies, bifurcation, new creations, denotification, etc., to make sure that no Panchayat halka or no panch constituency misses out on the elections. You are well aware that the elections were last held in 2011 and were held on the basis of ballot boxes and ballot papers. We follow the same process this time also. We are going to use ballot boxes and the ballot papers for the elections. There are going to be sarpanches as well as panches, because the sarpanch, which was not direct in January, By an amendment, the government has made the election of sarpanch also as direct. Therefore, the election would be of sarpanches as well as panches. Now, for the panch as well as sarpanch, there will be two separate ballot papers. The pink ballot paper will be used for sarpanch and white ballot paper will be used for the panch constituency. Just like in the municipal areas, a person can file nomination from any ward within the municipal area. In the same fashion, in a Panchayat Halka too, anybody who figures in the panch roll, in the panch ward roll, in any of the panchayat, any of the panch wards in the Panchayat Halka, he can file a nomination in any of the panch ward. The person has to exist in the electoral roll in the Panchayat Halka, not in the panch ward, but in the Panchayat Halka. So, and as for sarpanch is concerned, the person has to be an elector of that Panchayat Halka. In addition, we have facilitated the nomination process by appointing a large number of ROs and AROs. Almost at each, for about every Panchayat Halka, there is one ARO, and about 3 to 4 AROs are then looked after by one RO. In areas which are very far-flung, we have tried to increase the number of ROs and AROs just to make sure that people do not face any difficulties in regard to filing the nominations. In this election, there are no proposers. A person nominates himself or herself. Also, the person can authorize somebody else as authorized agent, because Panchayat Act right from the beginning always had this provision that somebody who wants to nominate himself can always send his nomination paper through an authorized agent. The same process, the same provision continues to be there. Also, the oath which is to be sworn can be sworn before an executive magistrate first class or a judicial magistrate first class, in addition to, of course, the RO and the ARO.